Hi everybody, my name is David. I just purchased a set of Gigagolf clubs, and seeing as there is very little online, I thought it might be nice to do an unboxing of all of them. So here's how they arrive. You've probably seen this from other unboxings on YouTube, but just pulling them out. Go. These appear to be the irons. Nice. Oh wow, you can feel those grips, they feel really nice and soft. Here we go. Wow, the handles look amazing. Yep, there's my irons and one of my what is this? Looks like a hybrid. Yep, so in there it says 3 hybrid. And here are some of my irons. I hopefully have more irons in there because I think I've ordered a bit more than that. I also bought myself some head covers so that my hybrids and head covers don't get damaged. These Golf Pride wraps that I've got feel amazing. So it's pretty good. So here we go. Here are the irons. There's 3 wood. And let me just have a little bit of a look at this. So so this is the TRX. Three hybrid. It says I've got 20 degrees maybe of loft. That's not what it said. It said 18 degrees when I ordered it online. That's a bit different. It's not so good. What's this thing here say? Oh no, it's the numbers on the bottom don't necessarily correlate to loft. So that's a good thing. But this is basically as it looks. On the YouTube video that's available for the 3 woods, so I'm not going to bore you guys to tears with that. You can search that one out. The golf grips I bought, I've got fairly sizable hands, so I bought myself some oversized grips for a little bit extra, and for somebody who's really struggled to hold other clubs, I find this is actually really, really good. So I'm very excited to get out there. I ordered some stiff shafts, and they feel, good drink, a bit of a bend, they feel really strong, so that's good. Wow. Anyway, so there's the hybrid. There's the hybrid and the fairway wood next to each other, so you can get a little bit of a comparison. In terms of distance across, it appears as though the hybrid is a little bit less. That's my dog trying to get in, just to be part of the fun. Sorry about the noise in the background. And here we go. What's this one here? So this is the P3. Now this is the part of Gigagolf that I really didn't quite get a fair appreciation of, because when you look online you don't necessarily get to see what it looks like when you're kind of looking down in here. And so that's the part of this video that I really wanted to highlight. So this is the 8 iron, and already you can see that it's got a really nice deep cavity, so that'll really help me to keep my weight low behind the ball, which will help me to elevate up into the air. It's got the titanium insert, which based on a very rough feel is very, very flush. And you can see, I mean, that's all available online, you can see the offset and things like that there. Looking from the top line, it's very straight. I mean, that's kind of what I'm used to I've got a very old set of Australian-made Max Fly golf clubs, which are also cavity back, but the cavity in the back of them compared to the cavity on this is vastly different. I'm just noticing just on the inside edge, sorry for taking it out there, you can see that there's actually some defects here in the club, and I'm a little bit concerned about that, but hopefully that's not going to make any difference. I'm imagining that in this particular section here, because that's right behind where the ball is going, that that's going to help with the sweet spot and really get some really nice power into the golf ball and things like that. So that's basically the 8-iron, which is the strongest lofted club that I got. I'll see if I can just quickly have a look and see how that compares to the pitching. The 9, I'll put those ones aside there. You're probably not interested in seeing the same thing over and over again. This is my gap wedge, and my lob wedge. So this is the highest loft, and this is a 60 degree loft. And in terms of the angle, I don't know if you can see it very easily, but actually that's a little bit disconcerting. That as you can see, the lob wedge has come already like shrink wrapped, but the 8-iron came and it was already unwrapped, so I'm a little bit disappointed with that, but it's neither here nor there. Hopefully I'll just double check and see, yeah, because it's a long way from Australia back to America. Yeah, there is I'm just seeing it's probably not so obvious through the foil, but there does appear again just to be some little kind of minor imperfections just along where my index finger was running there on this club as well. So I think it's more of the nature of the club rather than actually like a damage potentially in transport and things like that. But yeah, geez. Yeah, makes me wonder about whether that 8-iron is part of the returns policy that Gigagolf has got. Maybe somebody else has already had it and maybe they gave it a bit of a ding and then they shipped it off to me. But it's here in Australia, and to get it all the way back to America and then back here to Australia again is a bit of a mission. So it's probably best just to play with it and things like that. But overall, my first impressions are very good. The imperfection on the 8-iron is going to make absolutely no difference to the face of the club. As I said, that appeared wonderful. So I'm not at all concerned effectively by the blemish. Basically, it's not even really a defect or anything like that, I don't think. So I'm really excited to go out into the course, give these a bit of a go, and hopefully with a little bit of luck improve my handicap, which is not good. I'm up in the 30s, so just so you guys know. But I thought it would be good just to get myself a brand new set of golf clubs. I've had a good excuse to basically do so with COVID and all that type of stuff. And also I've been looking for a new hobby, and golf seems to have done an amazing job. But overall, yeah, very impressed. The way I line my shots up, I really like that white line at the bottom there. It really helps me. Bye for now. I'll probably upload some videos of me at the range, and probably do a bit of a product review after I've played a few rounds and things like that. So bye for now, and gosh, it's been almost 10 minutes, and thanks very much for being here. Overall, very impressed with the state in which they arrived, just looking forward to giving them a go. Thanks. Bye.